Okay, so first and foremost, we would like to advise Mr. Robert Anderson on which method should be used in between labor and capital intensive based on the results obtained in the reports. So when it comes to production, direct material costs and as well as other costs are taken into consideration. Okay, so first and foremost, we talked about direct material costs. So for this case, copper as well as chemical D is used in production as direct materials. Okay, so for cost of copper, when machines are used, it is able to reduce the cost of copper as there's only 2% copper loss compared to 10% copper loss in labor. So this gradually reduces the cost of copper in for machines. Same goes to when chemical D is used in machines as well. It's able to reduce the evaporation rate loss as it only evaporates by 4% in machine service. But when labor are used instead, it tends to have a bigger evaporation rate loss by 25%. Okay. So for cost of other materials used, when machines are used, you are able to see that we are able to reduce the cost of other materials by 50% as compared to labor. The amount of cost of other materials labor is 2 times the amount of cost of other materials in machines. So this indicates that a high copper loss is due to human error. Because humans, they tend to make mistakes, that's why they're not so efficient. And machines are specifically designed in a way to reduce evaporation rate loss. So this really, really benefits a lot. So it signifies that machines are much more reliable than labors. In other words, it is more efficient and effective at the same time, as it is able to increase mass production, meaning that more products can be generated at a shorter amount of time. Not to mention it is cost efficient as well. Okay, but the one disadvantage regarding machines, right, machines like this, is that they tend to have a very high depreciation cost each quarter, where it depreciates, where it tends to depreciate by 4,000 to 5,000 per quarter. So this leads to a significantly high operational cost. So, and when labels are used, right, labels do not depreciate. So that's the good thing about using or deploying labels instead. So, we all know that by using machines, we are able to reduce the cost of direct materials and other materials used. But we have to take some factors into consideration, such as the high depreciation cost, which is around 4,000 to 5,000 approximately per quarter, as well as the high rental cost that greatly outweighs the lower reduction in cost of direct materials and other materials used in machines. So as a result, it tends to lower the operational cost, which would increase the net profit when labels are used instead of machines. As you can see, the amount of revenue generated is the same for both cases. So the only difference is the operational cost, which I mentioned just now. When machines tend to be higher than that of labor. So in conclusion, I would advise Mr. Robert Anderson to use labels instead of machines, as it tends to generate a high.